Hey, welcome back. Giorgio Martini asked, can you please create a video on how to create step sequences that generate a melody on a click in scale? And of course I can, and I'll show you this in this video. And we need to have a polygrid in place on this track here, and we leave all the default modules in place because we need at least to generate a sound. And then we need to create a clock, and I use a scaler for that and one phase input, and we check up or we wire up the phase in to the scaler. And now we need some kind of counter to actually create some kind of step sequencer, and I wire this up, as you can see. And now every time a tick comes in or a cycle is done, we raising this number here, so we have some kind of step sequencer going on. And I use display to show you what the problem is now, because this counter here actually gives us a division of one. So not a real integer in case of a whole step, so 1, 2, 3 and so on. And we need to apply some bit of math here, and I use multiply the output of this, and we use a constant, and constant needs the number of divisions we have, so 8. And you can see we get now a nice clean integer, so 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. And with this we can work out a small step sequencer, and for each step we need at least one dice to generate our random note with the trigger. And we need a constant that defines our step number. In this case it's 1. And we need the comparing module. I think it's in the logic here. So this. And we need one select module as a gate signal. And I show you what I do now is to go out with this comparing to our constant. So every time the output of this is the same as the constant, then send a trigger signal to this select box here. So every time we reach 1, basically, I make this a bit faster, you can see we switch this on. And now we have some kind of small step sequencer going on, and we need to pass through our note signal, which is randomly generated by this dice here. And yeah, we need to create now multiple steps of this. So this is our second step, our third step, and our fourth step. So let's go with 4 here, 4 and 4. And now you can see we switch, can switch through all these steps quickly. And we need to go at least with 5. And now all we need to do is to create a sum module. And we can use this now as an the dice signal is basically outputting the same number, so we need to trigger it first. So let's use a trigger, this one. Now we have exactly what we want. We have multiple steps that's switching through with the scaler here. So we have step sequencer, and we have random created nodes with its dice and with this trigger. And every time we use the trigger, we have different pitch signals. But you can see the notes are pretty far apart from each other, though it's not sounding like a melody, right? So we need to narrow the signals a bit down, and we can use the a pitch scaler here. And we can define a range in between we want to have the signals. So let's go with C3 and maybe C5. So it's still pretty random, because it's random. And what we can do now is use at least one pitch quantize module here to narrow it down further. So we select here some notes we want to have. And this is basically our small step sequencer with random generated nodes for each step. It's pretty basic, but you can advance or create more modules to define how you want to have it. And you can also create, of course, some kind of gate signal from the scaler here. So pretty nice. And what you can do also is, because someone asked me, can you please make a tutorial on how to use logic operators like smaller, bigger, etc. And we can use at least one button here. And this AND module, we go in here, we go in here. And this is basically the first or the easiest way to use a logic operator. So we have a signal coming from the scaler, and we have the button activated. So we have two signals. And because this is a logic operator, it says this is true and the bottom line is true, then send out a signal. Yeah, I think that's it. A basic, small, random step sequencer to generate melodies. It's basic, but you can see, you can follow the setup, and you can develop it further if you want. And yeah, thanks for watching this video, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.